Dell's latest XPS 15 2-inch-1 is the world's smallest and thinnest 15.6-inch convertible. It's also one of the first to feature an Intel CPU paired with an AMD Radeon Vega MGL GPU, giving you some pretty decent graphics muscle for a super slim 2-in-1 PC. You might think that high-performance components fitted into a body that's only 0.63-inch, 16mm, at its thickest might not be the best idea and, well, you'd be right. Dell developed a special cooling system for it that includes two large liquid crystal polymer fans and three composite heat pipes, as well as synthetic graphite heat spreaders and Gore thermal insulation to help protect your lap from heat. And it all works well together, offering up performance to handle everything from office work to content creation and gaming, even if that last one isn't this PC's purpose. Granted, there are a few compromises for the design and it's pricey, with my review system going for $2,350, £2,199 and $3,899. If you don't need the 2-in-1 design, consider the XPS 15 laptop, which ends up being a better deal for the money. Being a 2-in-1, though, you can use it as a laptop, of course, but it's also a tablet. A big 15.6-inch tablet that weighs 4.4 pounds, 2 kilograms, which is not light, but is less than its closest competitor, the HP Spectre X360-15, which uses the same Intel AMD chipset. Dell has a new $99 premium active pen that has 4,096 levels of pressure sensitivity and tilt functionality for detail shading. The pen is good with relatively little lag, but the tilt support is going to depend on the application support. Still, it's definitely nice to have, and the pen itself magnetically attaches to the left side of the body. You can get the system with your choice of a Full HD display with 100% sRGB color gamut or a 4K UHD resolution touchscreen with 100% Adobe RGB color gamut. Both are capable of hitting 400 nit brightness without shifting the white point of the panel. The 4K display is beautiful, and that 400 nit brightness really helps with reflections. Out of the box, it had very good color performance, and Dell has a utility to set the screen to different profiles and you can calibrate to improve color accuracy. Getting that display adds $400 to price and requires you to step up to the Intel Core i7-8705G processor. Also, it will drain your battery faster than this Full HD. Because of the super thin bezels around the sides and top of the display, Dell put the webcam below the screen. It's an awkward position for video calls and for using the IR camera to sign into the PC with facial recognition. There's a fingerprint reader built into the power button if you want to use that instead. Mixed feelings on maglev. This is one of Dell's first laptops with a new keyboard using Darfin's maglev design combined with the butterfly mechanism. It uses magnets to pop the keys back up instead of traditional rubber domes, which allow Dell to make a thinner keyboard that it says will last longer than rubber domes. The keys have a satisfying clickiness to them, but there is little travel to them. I hit keys hard when I type, so it wasn't the most pleasurable experience using the keyboard for long periods of time. Also, the keys are nearly flush with the body, and if I wasn't careful or was typing especially fast, I ended up with extra letters from surrounding keys. Also, its thinness costs you legacy ports, with Dell switching to 4 USB-C ports, 2 Thunderbolt 3, 4 lanes of PCIe Gen 3, and 2 USB-C 3.1. Because of that, they'll need some adapters or a dock to handle peripherals. There's just a micro SD card slot, so anyone working with full-size SD cards is out of luck. Creative potential. Dell's XPS 15 2-inch-1 is a big step forward for the 15.6-inch convertible category. Once you get over a 14-inch screen size, convertibles start to feel clunky and cumbersome in a way that this Dell doesn't. And it doesn't really sacrifice performance or features to get there. That said, the smaller body does require some sacrifice, so if you don't need the 2-in-1 design, consider getting the regular XPS 15 laptop instead.